you're watching.
Values.
Perspective.
Guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. I do videos about veganism, bodybuilding, and about psychedelic plant medicines / spirituality. Today we're going to talk about all of those things because you've guys been asking me quite a lot lately, Bobby, how can it be that you say that you are spiritual but you're still into bodybuilding, you're still into building the body? Isn't that an egoistical approach? How can that coexist? Isn't that a contradiction, the body and the spirit? I believe that if you do bodybuilding, that is a very egoistical approach. All right, guys, so let me clarify as much as I can. In my mind, the body is the spirit. Everybody has a plan until he gets punched in the face. Mike Tyson, a great quote. What does it mean? You are perceiving your own reality subjectively, obviously. So therefore, you have the freedom to have all kinds of thoughts in your own mind, in your own spirit, if you will. But if somebody punches you in your face, if somebody affects your physical body, your physical manifestation, that will impact your mind. Even if somebody tells you a joke externally, that information gets into your brain and then you experience joy, you experience laughter. But what if somebody tickles your physical body? The same effect will hold true. And therefore, in my mind, the body is the mind and vice versa. Every little psychological issue that you have will manifest in your body, and every ailment that you have in your body will manifest in your psyche. If your body is sick, your mind will get polluted, and vice versa. Those things are coexisting, and in my opinion, they are the exact same thing. Two sides of the same coin, so to speak. In this universe, everything is a duality and everything will contradict itself to some degree. Even me doing videos on YouTube, I'm sure that I will contradict myself in future videos. This is just what makes us human. This is what we found out in this duality. It is totally normal. It is human nature, if you will. But in the grand scheme of things, in the bigger picture, everything is one. So therefore, to separate the body from the mind is a fallacy to begin with. That out of the way, I really don't understand why still to this very day there is this misconception of the body being not spiritual. I really believe that this goes hand in hand with Christian dogmatic belief that the sin is in the flesh, that every sin is made up by the flesh, and hence it is bad, and hence it is not spiritual. I highly disagree with that concept, because all those other practices that originate from the human body, such as yoga or tantra, must be not spiritual as well, by that definition. So therefore, to cut to the chase here, talking about bodybuilding, is it only egoistical? Is it only something that is practiced by someone to please other people, to show other people how grandiose one is? I highly disagree. Of course, that holds true in some people. And of course, when I started out with 16 years, there was obviously some extent of egoistical pursuit in that endeavor. Of course, I wanted to have big muscles to get the girls, so on and so forth, to be the strongest kid and whatnot. That is totally normal in the beginning, but growing older and still constantly practicing bodybuilding, it actually becomes a spiritual practice in its own right. When I work out, when I personally go to the gym, it is not that I identify with my body and I look at my body and think about myself, so to speak. Oh, wow, look at my biceps. Wow, look at my ripped abs. How fucking great. No, it is quite a distant feeling. It is me looking at this meat vehicle, molding and shaping it, creating a piece of art, if you will. And of course, in combination with veganism, it becomes very altruistic, because now your gains become righteous, if you will, because you are not harming anyone by getting your own benefits out of it. You're molding a physique, you're creating a masterpiece. Every time I hit the weights, every time I break a personal record, every time I squat, I deadlift, I bench press, I feel the weight on my chest, on my back. This is a very transcendent experience. If anything, I start forgetting about myself. If anything, I die ego death in the gym. I come close to nothingness. It is quite the opposite. An egoistical approach? Not at all. If anything, it becomes pure love. Me giving my body what it needs, creating a healthy, strong body, manifesting a meat vehicle that will assist me in my everyday pursuits, a strong body, a healthy body that will aid my personal endeavors. If anything, this becomes a no-self experience, an absolute dissolution of the ego. So, bodybuilding, an egoistical approach, an egoistical pursuit, quite the opposite. If anything, it is the pure manifestation of the spirit, the mind taking over the body and creating this vision, manifesting this vision in reality, taking the dream vision and manifesting it in the physical, taking the non-physical, the spirit, and bringing it into the physical realm. Directly your thoughts become things. Directly you're molding and shaping your physical appearance. If you perceive this is egoistical, you don't see the full picture. All right, guys, and this is it for today's video. Just a quick excursion into my thought patterns about body and spirit. If you like this type of video, leave me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so. And as always, guys, much love and peace.